Good afternoon, everyone. This is Tube 87. And to those of you who keep the Sabbath, happy Sabbath. May you all have a blessed day. Now, today's study is titled Homes Without Fathers. I hear all day long because of living it through family and other people out there. It's a very common story of the trials and heartaches that a lot of you mothers are going through being single mothers. And that includes you divorced mothers who are raising children, because it makes you all single mothers. It's part of the price that we all suffer because things are done out of order. And I'm going to go through scripture here with explaining from my viewpoint with what scripture says of some things that we need to keep in mind and do to ease this burden in the future, because a lot of you raising children are raising young daughters that are going to end up being in some of your same situations. And if they don't have these foundations and structures in their lives, they're bound to repeat the same things and go through the same heartaches that you're going through. So with that being said, let's get started. Okay, now let's go back to the beginning so we can get an understanding where all this started from, the Garden of Eden. Now, Eve separated herself from her husband, which she wasn't supposed to do. They were not supposed to be separated. Get it? Husband and wife, they're not to be separated. So, once she separated herself, she was doing something out of order according to the will of the Heavenly Father. Pause right there. Look at today, the same thing. Husbands are separating themselves from their wives, vice versa. We call it divorce and living our own separate lives and all these things. Once we do this, we subject ourselves to the temptations of the enemy. Back to Eve. She went to the tree because the enemy drew her there. She gave in to his smooth-talking ways and all this, and she committed sin. And then she presented the sin to her husband, who subsequently committed the same sin. Now, when their father called them out, neither one of them stepped forward and took responsibility. What did they do? Eve, the enemy, he tricked me, he beguiled me. Therefore, I committed sin, but it's his fault. That's what she was saying. And then what did Adam do? The woman, she presented this sin to me, so I did it, but it's her fault. And to this day, it hasn't stopped. There's continual finger pointing. No one is accepting their own sin, their own responsibilities for their sin. This is what we have to come away from, pointing finger. We have to own our own sin, accept responsibility, get on our knees, ask for forgiveness, repent, and move on. Now, part of the problem today is, as it's been forever, is that when we do these things out of order, we're going against the will of the Father. Now, for any of us, especially you young women out here, to think that there is not going to be a price to pay for having children with these men you are not married to, you are sorely mistaken, as you are living it now. Okay, the first thing that needs to be understood by you ladies out here, young and old, you have a tremendous amount of power and responsibility. Remember, with power comes responsibility, and you have the tremendous amount of it when it comes to this world. You bear all that is the future of this world in the form of these children. So you have a tremendous responsibility when it comes to bringing children into this world. Now, you have to do it in the appropriate order. Remember, we talked about in one of my previous videos about being equally yoked. You have to be equally yoked with a man who loves the Father first, as well as you. You have to love the Father first. You have to be submitted to him, as well as this man that you're going to have children by. These things have to be the foundation, first of all, before you get involved in bearing children into this world. Now, when we go out of order with this part, we create all sorts of chaos and a lot of burden and heartache, especially for you mothers who end up doing it on your own. Now, 1 Corinthians 7, 1 Corinthians 7, 1 and 2 it tells us, it says, it is not good for a man to touch a woman. Why? Well, I'll put it to you like this, because the lust of the flesh starts to take over. And verse 2 even tells us to avoid fornication. Let every man have his own wife and every woman have her own husband. So the word is already ahead of this game. We're not supposed to be touchy, huggy, feely, all this stuff with one another, because it leads to lust of the flesh. So understanding that you need that foundation, you also need to understand this, 1 Corinthians 7 verses 8 and 9. And it reads, it says, I therefore to the unmarried and widows, it is good for them if they abide even as I. But if they cannot contain, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn. So scripture is telling us that if you can't contain yourself, that lust of the flesh, if you have to do these things, it says it is better for you to be married than to commit this sin and burn in hell, in damnation. It's saying it is better to do this than to not commit sin. So one thing we already have to understand is that we have a foundation that we have to have. We have to be evenly yoked, and we have to be married to abstain from these things that are sinful and that are going to cause us all sorts of heartache and burden. So next, we're going to move on to what is the price of this. So remember, fornication is a sin, and we have to pay for all sin we commit. Don't ever think that there's not a price to pay for every sin we commit. Now, we can be forgiven, we can repent from these sins, and we do all this in the hope that in the end our sins will be blotted out. But for every sin we commit, we have to suffer the consequences. We can't commit a sin and go, oh, I'm sorry, Lord, please forgive me, and then that's it. No, we have to pay for that. Every sin has to be atoned. There has to be an atonement for every sin. And we're going to go through it, because now we have to be proven. We have to show the Father that we can overcome. Now we have to be an overcomer for the sin we committed. So we don't get away with this scot-free. And you mothers out here raising these children by yourselves, through whatever sin got you there, you have to overcome that. That is part of the price you're paying. It is sad, but it is true. Now, Romans 6:23 tells us, the wages of sin is death. Now, that's spiritual first, but we have to make sure that we overcome these things so we don't die physically in our sins. We have to overcome. We have to be overcomers. Now, Acts 3:19 says to repent ye therefore that our sins may be blotted out. Remember, I just said we have to ask for forgiveness, we have to be prayerful, we have to have faith and hope in the end that our sins will be blotted out. Now with that, we have to understand, especially you ladies out here, 1 Corinthians 6:19 says your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which in turn tells us in 2 Corinthians 6:16 that ye are the temple of the living God. So these bodies are not yours to do with as you will. Don't be beguiled or tricked like Eve by the smooth talking enemy working through men to end you up in a lot of these situations. These are not your bodies to toy with. We are to be using these vessels to do his will, and we are to be doing these things in order. Now, Romans 14:7 says that none of us live to ourselves. It's just what I'm saying. We don't live for ourselves, and none of us die to ourselves. Whether we live or die, we are his. So we have to understand this and do these things correctly. Now, 1 Peter 4:2 reads, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of God. So once we hear it, as you are now, start to get it and accept it and live it. We're to no longer live our lives according to the lust of our bodies or the will of other men. We're to live our lives according to the will of the Heavenly Father to remove and lift some of these burdens from us. Now, you mothers out here that are raising kids on your own, raise them in a way that maybe you haven't been raised in the will of the Heavenly Father. Because I'm here to tell you, especially you mothers with daughters, with little girls, if you don't raise your children according to the will of the Heavenly Father, your burdens and heartaches and pains are going to be tenfold. A lot of you are going to end up with daughters who are in their early teens, raising more children, and they're not going to be in the will of the Father, and it's going to get worse and worse. And some of you mothers out here raising young men, and I know some of you have lived it from experience and testimony, I've heard it myself, you're going to raise these young men, and they're not going to be in the will of the Father, and they're going to go out here, a lot of them are going to end up in jail or buried. And that is sad, but you have to get it. You have to stop pointing fingers and blaming the fathers, because you have this tremendous responsibility. You can prevent a lot of this. You can prevent most of it. Men are catering to their lust. You're catering to your lust, and you allow the men to do it to you, and then you expect a result different than what you're living now. It's not going to happen. You have to do things according to the will of the Father, or the enemy is going to win out through and through. You're going to be stuck raising these children on your own with all sorts of heartaches and burdens, and the fathers are going to go on living their lives in sin, doing whatever it is they want. A lot of them are going to end up in jail or in death, and then you're going to have to show their kids that the fathers are criminals or dead and all these things, because it's all done out of order. We all suffer and we all pay for it. And mothers, you can't expect the grandparents to carry the burden that you're shouldered with because of your iniquities. We can't bring everyone down. We have to accept and understand how we've gotten here and learn how to live and move forward with it. And it starts with the word. We can overcome this, and we can repent from it, and we can gain strength from it. But if we don't stop doing like Adam and Eve, pointing the finger, you're going to have long, painful lives. Accept where you are and how you got there, and start doing things in order now. And I'm going to close with Galatians 2, verses 20 and 21. And they read, it says, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Verse 21, I do not frustrate the grace of God, for if righteousness come by law, then Christ is dead in vain. So stop complaining, stop suffering yourself, and start living your life to the Father, and bring your children to the Father with you, and be overcomers, and let others see the change in you, and let your children know the Father, so they won't repeat the same mistakes and issues that a lot of us have. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father didn't call on us to be successful. He called on us to be faithful. This is 2 Bait 7. I'm out.